morning, everybody.
And can you say hi one more time?
Good morning. Hi.
That's really low.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Am I low?
Good morning. Welcome to the North St. Paul Maplewood Oakdale Rotary Club, the funnest club around. My name is Sonya Serpak, and I'm acting as president today in place of Kristen. And was everyone greeted today? Brian, thank you so much for being our greeter this morning. And Randy Greenlee, would you lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance? Yes, ma'am. Okay. United States of America. For which? Thank you, Randy. And let's see. Bruce Mogren, we haven't seen you for a while. Would you lead us in the four-way test or five-way? Five-way test.
Thank you. Yeah.
The five-way test of the things we think, say, and do. Uno. Is it fair and all concerned? Three, will it build goodwill and better friendship? Four, will it be beneficial to all concerned? And five, the important one, is it fun?
Is it fun?
Fun. Noemi, you could have answered back in Spanish. That would have been fun. Brian Buckmeyer, you were greeting. And also, do you have an invocation or words of encouragement for us?
I do. And this is going to be a little extemporaneous this morning. I'd like to, first of all, maybe just think about what is happening in the world right now, to think about those people that are being displaced, those people that are being killed for no reason at all, for the terrible leadership that is being shown in Russia, for the Russian soldiers that are being killed and not to their own liking. So for that, I ask that in peace, that our Creator look to the peace of the world and help us through these very, very difficult times. So with that, I'd like to just take a moment of silence for Ukraine, for the people of the world. God bless us. Amen.
Thank you, Brian. Randy, do you have a wake-up quiz this morning? Before you start, I have a quiz. I have a riddle. What is the only day that gives a command? The only day on the calendar that gives a command. What is the only day that gives a command? What day is today? Yes, March 4th. I know that because that was my mother's birthday. So we thought, and she always told us that today is my birthday. It's March 4th, you know, giving a command. And it wasn't until years later that we found out that she found out when she went to apply for her passport, she was really born on March 5th. So for 2 days, then we celebrated mom. But anyway, happy heavenly birthday to my mother. Okay.
And actually today, March 4th, is Jeannie's birthday. And now I know why I'm always being given orders for less. She doesn't watch. Okay, so I do have a Friday morning wake-up quiz. And last week's response time, 33%. Remember, we are looking for a person, place, thing, or event. Soon as you think you know the answer, yell it out loud enough that I can hear it. Number one, my roots go back to the days of Caesar. My name was registered with the U.S. Patent Office in 1932. I became permanently established in 1972 under the paternal hand of President Nixon. Mrs. John Bruce Dodd suggested me on Mother's Day. Why, kids, another tie you shouldn't have. Father's Day is correct, yeah. So back when men went to work wearing ties, years and years ago, when my daughter was 4 or 5 years old, on Father's Day, I got a big wide brown tie with a big yellow Tweety bird on it. And Monday morning, she was standing there watching me to see if I put that tie on to work, which of course I did. But I went looking for it because I was going to wear it today, but I couldn't find it. Number two, I was born in 1929, Jenkins, Kentucky, and died in 1977 as a traffic reporter when my helicopter crashed. I was the first to ever complete a flight over Russia. As a spy for the CIA, many in the U.S. were disappointed when I didn't use my cyanide pill in 1960. Gary Powers is correct. And let's see, April, do you know why they wanted them to use the cyanide pill in 1960? Do you know who Gary Powers was? He was a U-2 pilot. He got shot down over Russia. They flew U-2 was a spy plane. Got shot down over Russia. Sentenced to 10 years in prison. But after 2 years, was exchanged on a bridge in East Germany for a Russian spy. So he spent, anyway, then he became a helicopter pilot for.
And a major motion picture.
Oh, okay. Number three. Although I have a magnetic personality, I may give you a cold shoulder. What? It's correct. North Pole is correct. Boy, you're awake.
Joe is smarter than a fifth grader. He's got two of them. He's going to be really smart. Yay, Brian. Welcome. Thank you, Randy. It's always fun. And I'm glad you explained that just to April. Oh. Tyler, congratulations and welcome back. We want to hear all about your honeymoon. But what are Sergeant at Arms? We got Joe and we have Randy here. Isaac is out of town, I believe. So take it away. And hi, Ann.
Hi.
He's our only Zoomer here.
Good morning.
I'm surprised I'm the only one.
She's our Zoomerific Zoomer this morning. Well, good morning, everyone. Hopefully everybody's in good spirits this morning and looking forward to, I think that I keep hearing the word spring tossed around and I'm not sold yet, but I'm willing to give it a chance. Well, I told somebody the other day that spring is my favorite day of the year. So,
yeah, right. All I know is I cannot skate on my backyard ice rink, and I also cannot play baseball in my backyard. This is the worst month.
This is tweener time right now.
This is the in between.
Tweener, yep, exactly. I thought you meant you couldn't skate because you were like me and can't skate, well, but you actually probably
I also can't play baseball.
Doctor, it hurts when I do this. Don't do this.
Hey, I am really happy to be back in person.
It's good to see you.
About a month and a half. I knew that I had some important project interviews coming up, and those are behind me now. So I don't know if I got the work or not, but I'll just tell you guys that I went after the state office building, which is where all the House of Representatives are, and Interviewed for that on Wednesday, and I was nervous. I wanted to do it in person. I didn't want to get sick before that and not show up. For those of you that don't know, I did the state capitol restoration and the Senate building. So this would be the bow on the, I guess, is it a bow?
The
trifecta. Yeah. I like that.
Trifecta.
So that went well, and I have happy bucks to say that.
Fantastic.
We'll see if they give it to me or not.
But I when think you find out well. About what were some of the other ones, can you say what the other project you were interviewing for other ones as well?
Yeah, the History Center Museum is also doing a restoration. Wow. And went through that process. And then, well, just a lot of unknowns right now.
Right.
But I am working on the California State Capitol. Missouri called. They would like to do some work at the State Capitol again, mm-hmm. which I've worked on before. So it's been really busy at work. I've seen you as much as I've seen my kids lately. So happy to be here. Yeah, it was built in 91. So we remember it going up.
Unlike a YouTube plan you can jot down. Don't remember that one.
No.
I taught history Gary for Powell. Years, so I actually...
Yeah,
that's an option, right? I will also put in a couple of happy dollars here this morning for we have the end of students are there today, and then we start our spring break next week. And we actually it's a tradition at the school long before me. It's a 2-week spring break because we have a lot of groups that travel. So the happy bucks are also for we have a Morocco Spain trip. That leaves tomorrow morning. I'm not on that particular trip, but it is, they're able to go, which is really terrific. So, and then officially our mask optional as of Monday. So while there won't be many students the next 2 weeks, some athletes, but not much more than that. When we come back to school on the 21st, we will be a mask optional community. So
very
trending
good.
In the right direction in terms of all the data.
As will District 622, as far as I know. My kids are going back to optional as well.
Yeah. And I'm not sure how many, what our percentage will be in terms of those who still continue to. And I think actually, frankly, it's probably the adults more so than the kids.
Yeah. So, my twins are split. One's wearing a mask and one won't.
I think that's the case in many families that we're talking to as well. So that's okay. That's there's room for both in my mind. So I'll put in a couple dollars for that.
Very good.
This was going to be an announcement, but I'm going to give a happy bug because we have some thank yous from the elementary, Carver Elementary down south of 94 and also Transfiguration. So please read some if you want to share. That would be great. But anyway.
Who else this morning has some things I'd share?
Bruce, I'm coming back for you here.
On Sunday, I'm taking my family, my two kids, their spouses, and 5 grandkids. I rented a house in La Jolla, California, right by San Diego, a little beach town, and we're going to spend a week there. And then my son, because he took his family out to Pasadena for a week earlier this year, left his van out there, Vinny van. So him and I are going to take a cross-country trip back. From California back to Minnesota. So it'll be nice. Yeah. Yeah. It'll be look forward to it.
I will.
I just want to let you know, Rochelle said, please let Rotary know I am in Ixtapa, Mexico this week and next week. So
Ixtapa.
But is that as much fun as La Jolla that he's going to?
Well, that's where the seals,
not the Navy seals. They might train there. Yeah.
That's where the seals, winter, all
about that. And also, they have these tide pools where the supply goes out and
creatures.
Thank you.
So 5 grandkids,
600.
They'll have fun.
Lost my edge being online.
it takes a little revving back up to get back to using these things again. Any others this morning? Well, and again, Tyler, welcome back. It's hopefully you had a great time, and You look like you got some sun.
Yes.
Can't complain.
My oldest will be 15 tomorrow. And him and Ken are heading out on a boys' trip to New York tonight. So they're excited.
Wow.
I have to give in.
My youngest turned 23 yesterday. It's amazing because he's getting older, yet I'm not aging at all. And that's really kind of a gift. And my oldest turns 26 in about 2 weeks. So.
Very good. Well, so Sonya told the story of her mother's birthday, and I'm going to test my own memory here and put Mo on the spot. Mo, do you also have a similar story of your birth date and your, am I going down the right path?
I think I've told this to Rotary several times, but the situation was, we were going to visit our daughter in Europe, so I needed to get a birth certificate. And so called the county, Aiken County, and told them when I was born and so on. No records. She said, I'll call you back. My birthday was July 7th. She called me back and said, you were born on the 8th. So my mother was still alive then. I said, Mom, you didn't even know when I was born. She said, I know when you're born, but the doctor was drunk.
It's funnier every time. 7/7 was a good number to remember, though.
That's right.
My due date was 7/7/77. But I was late. I was a 7/11/77 baby. So those are still lucky numbers. Mm-hmm. Really? 7/11? Get a free Slurpee or something. If you're
that's a place you can.
They don't have those around here anymore, though.
Oh, they're so good, though.
So good.
Yeah.
So good. Any other happy?
I got all nostalgic. Like, oh, the Slurpees.
Any other happy bucks? All right. There must be. Is there anything else to do? I haven't been here in a long time.
We're handing it back over to.
All right.
Madam President for the day.
Yeah, and I'm wondering where our speaker is, but do we know, Nina?
I think I screwed up. I think we were on different time zones, so I have a feeling our speaker's going to show up at the wrong time.
Okay. Can you call her?
I'm looking for a phone number. Right, okay. She's an early riser, so she. Yeah.
Where did she? Where's she coming from? Where?
Oh, Tru Earth. They have a they have laundry detergent that comes with no liquid. It comes in, and I've been using it for a while, and I really like it. So that there's no water, so it's ecological, it's really safe for the water.
Why didn't you come up here and start talking? Because this happened to me last time I signed up to be president. I am not doing this again. Okay. First of all, wait a minute. Do we have any announcements? Any other announcements? Yes. Come up here. Randy, do you have any more quiz questions for us? Anybody have a birthday story they want to share?
Help. Okay, just a reminder, next Friday, March 11th at 8:45, we're going to have breakfast, coffee with the mayor of Oakdale. At the, oh, look who's here. Yay. We've got baby Lenny.
Hey, Kristen.
Hi, Kristen.
Hi. Sorry.
Can you hear us?
Turns out not.
Did we wake you up?
Yeah, clearly it's 7:20 and this is the best we can do.
Awesome.
Hi, everybody.
Oh, hi.
We're all thrilled to see you. How's baby Lenny doing?
He's doing good. He's doing better. We had a rough first month, but we're eating like a champ these days, so we're good.
Good.
And how's Mama doing?
Yeah. What was that?
How's Mama doing?
Good. Mom. I mean, I'm tired, but good.
What about Dad?
He's good. He is in a test here this morning and cooking right along. He's good.
Is he still getting good grades?
Yeah. Is he his only choice. Otherwise, he's not allowed back home. So
he's not home right now, though.
No.
Okay. Would you like to be the program this morning?
No, thank you. Unless it's just screaming when I take this bottle away.
We have a speaker that is not here yet. So.
Oh.
Nina is taking full responsibility for this. Okay. Noemi, do you want to continue? I'm sorry.
So yes. So next Friday, after this meeting, we're going to have a coffee at the Hy-Vee in Oakdale to meet with Mayor Paul Reinke. Just kind of to say, hey, how can we follow up for community engagement, partnership, all that stuff? So Randy Comfort will be there for sure, for sure. I think I'll be there. Like, if there's a couple more that would like to attend, again, just to really solidify our desire to be more involved in the Oakdale community.
Can you send something out to the club?
April, can you just send out an email with that info?
Yep.
Awesome. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Right after this meeting, 8:45 at the Hy-Vee in Oakdale on Friday, March 11th.
That's the one off of 10th there.
That's okay. The one and only in Oakdale. The Maple, the one with Maplewood will be on March 25th. Hopefully you're back. We'll be meeting with Mary Lee Abrams at the Hy-Vee in Maplewood, like right here on White Bear Lake or White Bear Avenue on the 25th. So if you can't make it on the 11th, the 25th at about 8:45.
Perfect. Thank you.
I have a thank you. It is from Margie Horning, and we gave a contribution to their club for a project. So she sent this thank you, and she said, to all of the North St. Paul, Maplewood, Oakdale Rotarians, thank you for your support in changing the lives of families in the village of El Corozo. We will send email updates so you can join us on this journey as we work with the residents to provide a dependable source of clean, fresh water. She says, thank you. So
wonderful.
Making a difference globally.
Thank you, Brian. I have a thank you as well here, actually, from one of the teachers over at Transfiguration. Actually, I had one from Carver, too. And I did not bring it. She's waiting to be admitted. Okay. She said, I am writing to sincerely thank you for the dictionaries you provided for all the students. What a gift. We had just started learning about using real dictionaries in class, and when these came, I was delighted. When they started using them, they were so excited with all the different information now at their fingertips. Now I have to remind them to put them away during class. Thank you so much for this generous gift. Sincerely, Sonia Ellsberg-Potcher, third grade teacher at Transfiguration. And I happened to open one of these. Actually, I looked at all of them, but one of them, he's so cute. Thank you so much for the dictionary. I look at James Madison's biography for a study, signed by Sharon and Annalise. So, I mean, it was so cute. Picture of them studying James Madison. But take some time, read through those. Thank you to April this morning for providing treats for us. Greeter Brian Buckmeyer, Meals on Wheels, Norm, you're on today. It's going to be nice, though. It's not going to rain, right? Oh, it's not snowing. And birthdays. Bruce, you have a birthday on Monday. I know that because it's the day before Ron's birthday, my husband's birthday. So happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Bruce. Yes.
An anniversary, we have the newlywed Tyler and Sarah, February 26th. Oh, it was just last Saturday. Oh my, when did you get back? Nice. And do you want to talk about the weather there, or? I think that's good luck, though. Yeah, let's hope. And Lisa Grayheck, today would be her, or March 2nd. I guess that was, what day is today? The 4th. So a couple days ago would have been her 4-year anniversary. So in Rotary. So with that, I have no other announcement. Oh, Randy, thank you.
So we have a kind of an interesting thank you note here. I suspect, I think it's from Avalie, A-V-A-L-I-E, but I suspect Avalie may suffer from being left-handed like I did because it opens backwards. Okay, so it's got a thank you on the front with a medal, but because it opens backwards, maybe just discovered too late that it wrote it on the wrong side, so it was labeled front and back. But when you open it up, you got to turn it like this to read the best dictionary and thank you, Rotary Club.
I was surprised at how many kids couldn't spell the word dictionary.
How can you misspell it?
No.
I didn't look it up.
Some adults.
Yeah. Anybody else? We're still waiting.
That is funny.
Like I said, this will be the last time I ever do this. Sign up. Okay. Next week. Next week's president is Noemi. Good luck to you, Noemi. Randy Comfort is going to be our greeter, and Joe Miller is providing food. We still need, and the following week is our board meeting on the 15th, and we need somebody to run that board meeting. So one of our board members, if you are interested, unless Kristen, you're going to be there at 7 o'clock on the 15th. Look at her.
I mean, I can try, but I make no promises in life right now.
Okay, perfectly fine. So, Kristen, are you back at, you're back at work, working from home?
Back part-time right now, and next week I start full-time back.
Are you able to Zoom, or are you able to, do you have to go in at all?
I'll go in a couple days a week. Okay. Yeah, but I'll do some from home.
Okay.
Which is nice.
Yeah. So Lenny sleeps a lot of the day. Oh, cute.
Oh, see, but here we are.
Adorable.
He's so cute.
We're making it.
I think.
Oh. You never know what's coming up, that's for sure.
And how much does he weigh now?
He's over 10 pounds, so he's on the curve, which is great. We were off the curve on the low side for a little too long, but we're making up for it in our cheek size.
Yeah.
Good chubby cheeks.
Yeah.
Cute. Yeah.
Great.
Well, good to see That's everybody. Great. I'm going to finish him getting ready, and I have a work meeting here soon, so.
Well, it's great to see you. We're glad that you hopped on here. And we're glad that we get a chance to meet little Lenny. Adorable. Yeah.
Thanks, everybody, for stepping up and doing president and food and just everything so I could be with this little guy. So thank you. I really appreciate it.
Well, we're happy you're home and able to be with him. Good to see you, Kristen.
Good to see you, Kristen. Good to see you.
You, Randy?
So, Sonya, you don't really have to continue to tap dance. You could just ring the bell and declare a social time.
Well, maybe we will. Should we just do that? Okay. How close were we to getting out early? Whoops.
Yeah, she's out in mountain time. So kind of like a teaser. Like Jim's dad would say, it's my 13th anniversary of my 60th birthday. I turned 30. I don't know what a time like. Yeah, it really is.
You know, I haven't taught for many years. I have to tell you, I taught for 18 years, and I feel like this is the dead time where you say to kids, do you want to play 7-Up right now? Heads down, thumbs up. Do you remember those days? I mean, back when you were a kid. But I realized the other day, my first class of second graders are now 50 years old. Can you, I mean, that just, it hit me. On my birthday, I thought, wait a minute, I started teaching 22 years old. These kids were about 8 years old. And I thought, this cannot be right.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Hey, just like so
who are we hearing?
Me.
But the time goes so fast. And I totally remember those days like yesterday. So I look at you, Joe, thinking of your little fifth graders going, they will be graduating before you know it. I mean, you blink and the time is, I mean, the days right now seem long sometimes, but as many of you know, the years go fast. Brian, do you have something? Noemi?
Just a quick announcement I failed to mention. Rochelle Pleska has accepted being president of our club for 2023-2024.
Great.
After
Randy.
Randy.
So,
are you talking to me?
That is great news.
It actually says that you've stopped the video.
So I have an educational question for you, Sonya. We were talking at our table. Remember when we learned how to write and we learned the Palmer method with the lines and the paper? Well, I've been looking at the thank you notes, and I think maybe it's time to go back to the Palmer method of writing.
I totally agree. Yeah, very few teachers are even teaching cursive anymore. I mean, it's one of those things. Did your kids learn cursive, Joe?
Yeah, in
fifth grade. Yeah, I mean, it's just one of those things that got pushed. I'm not quite sure where it is right now, but I know that it was dwindling, and I suppose in the computer age. I will tell you one story. I have a friend who is a third grade teacher, and they were learning the letter V, the cursive letter V. This is probably about 20 years ago, and they had to practice the small V's and the uppercase V's, and then they had to write a sentence with the small V and an uppercase V. And the kid came up to my friend, her name is Mrs. Doble, and he goes, Mrs. Doble, how do you spell Viagra Falls? And yeah, that was his V word.
Yeah.
And that's the last, that was the last time we taught cursive. But it used to be third grade, and now so
my kindergartner is learning to read right now, and I had my shirt on yesterday that said Cowern Elementary, and Cowern is in all uppercase print letters, and she said Cowern. Yep. I was like, good. I was like, what's the second word? And elementary's in script. And she goes, that's not a word.
I want to know how many of you play Wordle. Anybody? No? Oh. Okay, I thought everybody would be playing. I got on this bandwagon. I thought my 24-year-old niece, it's Wordle. New York Times puts out a word every day, and it's not an app. You actually go to New York Times, you Google it, and it Wordle. It'll pop up, and it's a five-letter word every day that they give you a new one, and you only get so many chances to guess this word. So you're hooked on it, Tyler. Do you compare who gets... Yeah. And you get six chances with this five-letter word. And actually, I've been practicing because there's an app that you can get called Word Guess. And that is actually like a free word game. And it's fun. It's really fun. It's kind of test your memory.
How do you know what word to put in there?
You don't. And so you just right away, you want to know, okay, first of all, Tyler, come up here and explain this. Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah. We have it. Okay.
Awesome. I'll get online.
It looks like this.
So you know how many letters there are to start with?
It's only five.
It's always five?
It's always five. So you think of a five-letter word.
So looks like...
Party.
Looks like that. Okay.
Okay.
So name of the game is... I usually like to start with a word that has a lot of vowels, because if you get a lot of vowels, then it kind of helps. So I'll start everybody out. I like to start with the word ado, because it has A-E-I-O-U. No, A-E-I.
I-E-U.
Yeah, what is
it? A-E-I-E-U.
So this is what it looks like. Once you guess, the green means the letter is in the right place. The yellow means that the letter is in the word, but it is not in the correct place. And gray means it's not in the word at all.
So if you want to fill in.
What's the word that you
know?
A-D.
A-D. Yep. I-E-U.
So we said no to the
letter. A is correct. D is in the word. E is in the word, but not in the correct place. So D and E. Yep. So no I, no you. Okay. So let's get another five-letter word. Yep.
Okay. And E and A.
D and E. Yep. So
there's multiple A's. Does it say that? Or
it does not.
So it just tells you that an A is correct, whether there's two of them or one of them.
Correct. So for strategy-wise, I usually try to get something with like T, S,
So we need a word that begins with A and has a D and a D in there.
I don't like to do adapt.
Ace. Do you want to say adapt?
We want to do adapt? Well,
no, adapt doesn't have
D. I was going to say.
D-A-T-T.
And you can make guesses where it just gives you information. You don't necessarily have to continue on with your current spaces. So a lot of the times I'll just throw another like word to get, like I'll do like super or something like that. So
acted.
He's
a teacher. You got to raise your hand.
All right. So here's what we know so far now. So we know that the D, it ends in D, starts in A, and the E is still not in the correct, but there's no C and there's no T.
Wait, you don't have one person supplying the word, the computer supplied the word, and you're trying to guess what the word is.
That's correct. So who's got a word that starts with A, ends with D? Five letters.
Is there an E in there?
Everybody gets the same word.
Is the E in the right?
Nope, E is not in the right place.
So in the no T and no C?
Correct.
Avoid.
Because
there's got to have an E in there. So. No I. See, this is where it gets tough.
Okay.
We can look up here too. We have the A and the D.
Am I? No, I'm not sharing a screen.
Oh, yeah, we can.
Oh, no, because I'm not set up for that with this laptop. So, no, I'm okay.
We got her.
Okay.
We'll pick this up later.
Okay, Nina, do you want to come up and introduce our speaker? Welcome. We're glad you're here.
Thank you.
So glad we got this worked out. So Wanda Liski is the affiliate manager for Tru Earth, which is a Tru Earth, which is a, well, I'm going to let her explain what it is, but she's got an offer for a way that we could possibly do a fundraiser where we don't have to do any really extra work. So take it away.
Okay. Sorry that there was a technical delay, but I'm here and I just want to host that. Okay. Somehow I have a banner. Oh, there we go. So I'm Wanda Liski and I am the fundraising manager for Tru Earth. Tru Earth fundraising was set up. We were a year old in August. So we've been coming up to 2 years now, about a year and a half. We were originally set up because my brother Brad is one of the co-founders with Tru Earth, and he wanted to give back, and my background is in fundraising, so he asked if I would set up the fundraising program. So we did that back at kind of the start of the pandemic, or, you know, into the heavy part of it. Actually worked extremely well because a lot of groups couldn't fundraise, and people were used to doing in-hand fundraisers and they just couldn't do that any longer. So this worked well. And because it's borderless, it can go anywhere in the US and Canada. It's a link that we give you that you create, you tell us what you want it to be called. We create the link for you. And that link can then be shared with anybody that you know anywhere in Canada and the US, including Hawaii and Costa Rica. So, and everyone that you share your link with and they purchase Tru Earth goods through your link, you make 20% on every sale that's made. You also, the person purchasing also gets free shipping to their home. So it's contactless. And it can be done year round. So there's no start, there's no stop. It's continuous. So it's kind of a perpetual passive fundraiser that continues to produce revenue for you, depending on how active you are. We do give social media posts that you can share. We give you graphics that you can create your own. We have events. We try to have something every month. In March, our two events are from the 18th to the 20th is kind of a, we haven't called it anything yet, but a spring cleaning event. And what it does is we'll give a code, a post with a code, and they, when you share that and they go into your link, and when they shop, they enter in that code and it gives them 15% off. So the nice thing too, I'll just go back for a minute, is that because the shop page that we create for you is just a mirror of the actual Tru Earth shop page, it will always give the supporter, the person shopping, the best price. So no matter what price, you're never overpaying, which is a great thing because a lot of fundraisers, you know, have jacked up the price so that, the fundraisers always, person buying always feels like, oh, I'm paying double for this. But you're with the Tru Earth one, you're on the actual shop page that a normal person would see, except at the top of yours, it would say, welcome to your group name. And then it just basically says, the other event that we have coming up is March 29th, and that's actually a 25% commission boost. So instead of the 20%, that one day, everything that is purchased through your link that day will give you 25% commission instead of the 20%. So that's a great, so both of those events are good events to promote with your fundraiser. So, because they both benefit, the one benefits the supporter and you always get, you know, your 20%. And the other, the last one benefits you because you get that extra 5% commission. So we found those have actually, we've had almost, we've now at 700 fundraising groups. Actually, sorry, almost 800. I think we hit 780 yesterday. And so that we actually, on the commission boost days, we actually get probably 3/4 of our fundraisers active during that one day, which is quite amazing. The other, so, and then in April, because Earth Day is a big deal for Tru Earth, because our critical cause is helping to save the planet and trying to keep plastic out of landfills. The whole month will be different events taking place that you can promote with your supporters. And the other thing I want to just tell you about this is that link is shareable to anybody. So you don't have to even know who's purchasing through your link. So if you share it with your sister in, I don't know, New York, and then she buys some stuff, loves it, she shares that link then to her friend who buys some stuff, and her friend shares it to her mother who's in Hawaii or in Canada, you don't know who actually shared that link. And personally, you don't really care. Your organization is making 20% from that. So we always kind of say that everybody knows somebody who you don't know. So that's how the link is so easy to share. The other thing that we're actually running right now is we're donating 1,000 loads, which is a $500 value for every fundraiser that signs up before Earth Day. And it go and we donate it on your behalf, so in your name, to a charity, like a food bank or shelter in your area. So it might be not in right in your city, but it would be the closest one that we have a connection with. And a lot of the food banks that we actually donate to are shelters. They're hub food banks. So then they also, that food bank, I'm sure you know about food banks, they then offload to smaller food banks that don't get as many donations. So that's another thing that we're doing. So if you were to sign up, your group was to sign up with the fundraising before Earth Day, we would donate 1,000 loads on your behalf, your name. And then we will actually give you the name of the food bank that it was donated to so that you can post that on your website. But maybe a lot of you are wondering what Tru Earth is, and I can definitely show you. This is the 8 load. This is becoming different size loads. So 8, 32. I'm not sure if anybody's seen a actual load. We found actually these little 2 loads are actually quite nice for in hand. If you ever are doing any in hand fundraising, these are quite good because you buy them for like $20 something. And you can sell them for $3 or whatever you want. And then you put your sticker. We give you a QR code as well. You can put your QR code on the back. Once somebody tries it, then all they have to do is take a picture of it and it would go right to your shop page so they can purchase more. But they're actually quite nice for just little gifts. If you ever want to give a little thank you gift, we've had those. The nice thing about these is that I'm just going to open this one here because I don't have it here, just so you can see what it looks like. So we've made it so that this is 2 loads right here. So you can just rip it in half. And then what I do, I have a HE front load. So I just rip it up like this and throw it in my drawer where I normally put my liquid soap and then pop it in and works. Or if I'm
How long is laundry soap?
Pardon me?
laundry soap. They don't have laundry soap.
Yes, sorry, I guess I forgot to say. And so if I'm washing a mask, I'll just rip off a little piece and throw it in the sink and do my hand wash. Or if I just have a little stain on a piece of clothing before I put it in the wash, I'll dampen the stain, rub it in, and then it's all totally gone. So yes, so this is one load. If you have a heavy load, then I usually will do maybe two strips or one and a half, but basically I just rip it into little pieces. The nice thing too is that if you're traveling or if you RV, anything like that, this takes no space. Like this is a huge one. This is 64 loads. So that's that. And just stop me if you have any questions, because I'm kind of doing this on the fly. Since my computer, I lost a lot of stuff without my large computer not working. This is the multi-surface cleaner. So this is actually a cleaner that you actually roll this up like this, throw it into a spray bottle, add a cup of water, it can be hot or cold, and that's your cleaner. So you never actually have to buy cleaner. If you were going to do a toilet, you can just rip a piece of this off and throw it in your toilet bowl, and then it cleans your toilet. Just use the brush, and that's it. So no liquid, no plastic jug. I'm sure probably a lot of you have already seen dryer balls, but we do have the wool dryer balls. They're actually, there we go. There you go. They actually cut my drying time by half. So, and especially on the big blankets and stuff, just keeping them, or sheets, keeping them from all balling together. So it really cuts back. So we've got numerous products. I wish I would have got the one, I'm not sure it is. Produce bags, and we've got grocery bags. We just came out with pop-up sponges, which compostable, which are very cool. They are great. We've got the metal straws, so no more plastic. Comes with a little brush. We have bamboo cutlery, so in place of plastic cutlery. So if you're camping or going for picnics, that's a great item. And then the other thing about the laundry soap, it comes in a bait for babies. And it also comes, this is a, you can't really see it because it's small, but it's a fresh linen. Or no, this one is fresh linen. This one here, I guess, this one's fragrance free and fresh linen. So there are numerous products. You can actually go on, I wish I could, maybe I don't think I could find my the Tru Earth shop page, but I will try to send, does it work if I send links after so that you can bring them up on your own computer? Or
yes, if you send them to me, I'll send them out to the club.
Okay, I'll send my test link just so you can see what a shop page looks like, but because I don't want to send somebody else's link just in case. I don't want you guys shopping on somebody else's link. You may as well get your own link. So the other thing about the Tru Earth fundraising is there's never a cost to you. So we set up the link for you. We set up a share a sale account for you, which you go in and the organizer would go in and finish the setup. But there's never a fee for that. And it just, money just goes in there. And you've done nothing. Does anyone have any questions?
If we already have an account, can we switch over so that the club, because I already use this, can I switch it over so that the club gets credit?
Yeah, you can just cancel it and then restart it under yours.
Cool.
Yeah, because there's never a fee for canceling a subscription. Yeah. So, but the thing about the subscription, I'll just tell you, is that we can't, it's the The 20% is on the first purchase of the subscription. And that's because we don't follow credit cards. Like we can't, it's a privacy thing. So like it can't keep watching your credit card to see when the order renews, right? So what we tell people is, if you're wanting to do a subscription, do a annual subscription, or realistically, you can do your subscription, then cancel it and then redo it. It doesn't, you know, but most people, right, with subscriptions, only 1 in 3 keep it going. And the reason is they'll find that they're either getting it too often or not often enough. And so what they end up doing is canceling the subscription and repurchasing on a sale, say, because you can get some really great prices on sales. So that's kind of how it works. So we don't follow a customer's name or credit card. What happens is we use Share a Sale, which is the link created through. So when somebody goes to the Tru Earth website, they go in, purchase, they pay Tru Earth, and then Share a Sale grabs that order number and the transaction amount, but not anyone's name or credit card. So that's the only information they grab. So the rest is all still in Tru Earth.
I have a question about the subscription. Do you have to do it via prescription, or can you just do one-time purchases?
Oh, one-time purchases. Yeah. You can purchase any package you want, anytime you want. Subscriptions are, like I said, 1 in 3 people keep their subscriptions going if they choose that. But no, typically an order is just placed for a package, or when we say Earth Day coming up, we'll have all these starter eco bundles. So it may be the dryer ball, a package of laundry soap, just that we make up these bundles. And so people try all the products and then they'll go back and repurchase another. So because there's no actual benefit to a subscription because your shipping's free anyhow, no matter what, right? So if you buy something for $10 on our website, your shipping's free. And we have three warehouses in the US now. So the shipping has gone down. So it's usually just a few days for you to get your products. Depending on what's Christmas is, and obviously since COVID, we've had the whole world has had issues with shipping, haven't they? It's just impossible, right? But it's getting better.
So if our whole group bought under one subscription as our Rotary Club, we'd all get, the club would get all the credit?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. If you wanted to all do a subscription or do one, get one big package and try it out. But yeah, if you like, quite honestly, if any of you guys are actually buying from Tru Earth, you may as well start the fundraiser because at least you're going to get 20%, right? It's, and there's no minimum, there's no maximum, there's no time frame. So the nice thing about the laundry detergent is it is consumable. So people have to continually repurchase their laundry detergent, right? And once you try the no plastic, it's hard to go back. Because you can, you go to Mexico or go to Europe and you just take some strips with you, right? Throw them in your bag. There's really nothing. Yeah.
Thank you.
And the setup is really easy. So I think, Nina, you probably have the link. It takes less than 5 minutes. And if it's during a weekday, we have your link ready for you, that same day.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah, thank you. Any questions? Any other questions? Well, we're glad that you were able to get online with us, Wanda, and we appreciate your information and might be worth something trying out. And if the clothes get clean, hey, we're all for that, right?
Yeah, so true. Yeah, and thank you for having me, and sorry about that. Of course, the morning that you, having issues, my you know, there's nothing I could do about that. And is it snow there? Do you guys have snow right now?
Yes.
A lot?
Where are you at?
Oh, I'm in Calgary. So yeah, we just got snow again.
Okay.
So, yeah. We're waiting for spring though.
So are we. We're actually forecasted for a wintry mix. I love that. A wintry mix.
Yeah.
So it's going to rain, we think, maybe tomorrow with that wintry mix. So, yes, we still have. You have no snow up there?
No, we just got snow the last 2 days. Okay. So our snow, because we're kind of just on the outskirts of the mountains, our snow, we get a lot of Chinooks. So our snow comes and goes. So, you know, last week we were at, oh, on Sunday, we were 14 above. Oh, so that's in Celsius.
Yeah.
So double that. We were like 60 above. And now, you know, we've got a few inches of snow. So, yeah.
Yeah. Well, we're going to have a heat wave tomorrow, 43 degrees. So,
there you go.
We can hardly wait. Well, thank you very much, Wanda. I appreciate you taking the time and getting up early and giving us information all about this. So, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. I wish I would have had a little more to show you, but do what we can. And enjoy your day. And I'll send you off those links just so you can share those.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
Okay. Have a great day.
You too.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Any other announcements for the good of the Brian?
Yes. You will now be able to be president again because we had a speaker.
Oh, yeah. That's a lot of dancing up here. I was ready to go into my old school stories. Human growth and development. There we go. Randy, do you have an announcement?
Just that I mentioned to April that maybe we would put for the board meeting, the upcoming board meeting, we put the fundraiser possibility to discuss it maybe as a board to anybody who can attend that, right? So maybe as a club, have a conversation around whether maybe that could be a spring, especially an Earth Day related spring fundraiser could be a nice.
Oh, yeah. Get some publicity for us there too.
We have a big fall fundraiser, but this would be, yeah. Might be a fairly soon spring
version. Yeah. Good idea. Tyler, huh? The baby shower is April 29th.
Okay.
It's a book. We've talked about that. Everybody will bring a baby book, a book that we are going to share with the women's shelter for the new moms. And also you need to bring a baby picture, but April 29th is the date. No, we've changed that. We thought it'd be too confusing to bring a bottle of booze and a baby book. It would. We had the fetal alcohol, gal talk. It's not a good thing. This is being recorded. Remember that. Tyler, you want to go up there and share the word? So Tyler, during just a few seconds, he figured this out. And the word, it actually has an E in there. And the word is ahead. See, tricky. You got to think. Use the old brain. Yeah. Yeah. So everybody, next week, I want you on Wordle and reporting back. How many tries it takes you. They'll give you 6 tries. After that, they'll go, sorry, here's the word. But it is fun. So anyway, thank you, everybody. Have a great day. Enjoy that wintry mix. And we'll see you next week.
Thank you.